Hey everybody, it's 4Wire. Welcome back to Metroid Zero Mission. We did a little bit of collecting in the last part. We got the various suit as well. But we've pretty much cleaned out Brinstar in its entirety, actually. As crazy as that seems. And we also did a lot of cleaning up of Kraid. We didn't clean everything up, but we cleaned most of it up. And that's not bad. Anyway, our marching orders are to go back down to Norfair in this part, and that's what we're going to have to do. I also did some sequence breaking that I'm not going to exploit, so sorry to disappoint you guys, but that's just not how I roll. I don't believe in sequence break. I think I've only, like, really sequence break broke a couple times through Metroid. And one of them was because I was really curious about that VAR beam glitch, where if you do it to the Mother Brain, you can somehow escape that room in the second phase. And then, basically, it almost functions as New Game Plus. You start way back at the beginning with all your stuff in tow, so you can end up conceivably with, like, 400 missiles and things like that. If you really wanted. But I believe the rate for collecting items remains unimpeded, because I also remember I did not hit 100. Despite what I did get. So, it's kind of weird in that regard. So, there's two ultra heated areas, and one of them that we have to go to is obviously the one underneath, where the high jump statue was. But there's one more, so you might as well just go and explore that for the time being. And snag something there. And that would be here. It's a little bit of a tricky area, because, well, Roots is here, there's a Nova's aplenty here, there's Squeeps here, there's also really thin platforms here. It is meant to be a bit of a challenging area, but one that nets us yet another missile tank. Which would be number 6 for Norfair. And also this little area, which is very conspicuous, but no matter how hard I tried, it looks to be a dead end. I beat up that area quite a bit last time I played this, and I don't believe I ever exposed anything there. And that disturbs me because I see those two squares. And I can't help but feel that. There's something there. There has to be something there. But when I go back and look, because I'm going to miss a few items, I'm going to get to the bottom of it. And I'm pretty sure, just by confirmation bias, I'm going to find something foul with that area. Because it just seems conspicuous. Why the hell do they have a Squeep just jumping around there for no reason? What possible reason is there? If not that. To sequence break or not to sequence break? That is the question. Nah! My misguided sense of honor is not gonna let me. And let's face it, it really is a misguided sense of honor. I'm definitely more than aware to say that. Anyway, we need to go back to the high jump area, so let's head there right now. Destroying all the Perugias along the way. Because, well, they are weak. The advent of being able to shoot A-ways sort of bastardizes most of those flying enemies, because before then, it was a lot trickier. You had to time it perfectly. And, well, that dissolve all shit. I think it just bastardizes the whole process. Yeah. Come on. This is not easy. Come on. Yep. Alright, fine. Hell with it. Really? Come on, game. Let me jump. Let me do this. Come on, you friggin' ass. Shit stain. Come on. Alright. Mild embarrassment aside, and flying enemies for reasons that want to take me out. This basically is more like a ski jump area. And I like ski jump areas, they're very enjoyable. They also allow you to jump like crazy. Which is exactly what I want. Then you just launch off here and you jump. So anyway, let's go. Charge! Right through here, you take that jump, you go through. And you meet up with a Nova for no reason. Oh, but don't forget these guys! who could take an absolute pounding. But of course, that's just the tip of the iceberg. We end up in here. There's a lot of splits here too, and a lot of it has to do with just bombable areas and stuff. So really, there's a bunch of rooms that you could just sort of ignore in their entirety, which is intriguing. Come on, get up, get up, get up. Thank you. And I believe this room right here you can almost entirely ignore if you wish. I'm just choosing not to for reasons that I can't quite figure out. Maybe it's just for the sake of the LP, just showing it off. Either way, oh, ow, owie, ow. Also, be aware of fake lava. That's right, some lava is fake. I don't know why, it just is. I never understood the whole illusion of the fake lava stuff. Like, what is... I know it's Metroid, and I know it's cute and all, but it's like, what's the point? What's the point of the fake stuff? What'd they do, just like use red dye or something? They probably did. And also Ripper 2s that exist. And that lava right there is not fake, from my recollection. Do I want to go up or do I want to go straight? I think I have to go here. Also, screw you, dragons. I don't like you. Dragons annoy me. But not as much as the original Metroid, because there were a few rooms like that in the original Metroid, and if you jumped in them and you misjumped, you were dead on sight, because you'd be put in an area where you were just helpless, which I felt to be really stupid. Like, really counterintuitive, in my opinion. Anyway, I'm not really sure where exactly I need to go. I do know that there is a missile tank right here, though, and I'm gonna take full advantage of that. There also are a couple of tricky missile tanks here, too, that if I believe I know where I am now, so this should, I think, ultimately lead to a dead end. And it looks like the dead end came a little earlier than I expected. But still, sense of accomplishment, yes. As ambiguous as the map can be sometimes, the rooms kind of definitively tell you, okay, dead end, you can't do crap here. And also there's something underneath, but we can't do anything about it. And we don't have the opportunity to really do anything about it. So, that's okay, we can live with that. And it looks like there's nothing up there. So let's continue onward. And we're gonna meet up with vines for some reason. Purple vines, you have the missile. And something like this, well. If you could just shoot that vine there in the Garuta, it would still come after you, which is kind of interesting. Here we are. This is what I'm looking for. Right here should be the magical item. And lo and behold, we're ran right near the key item too. Come here! Ah! That did a lot of damage. That did a lot of damage. But it's worth it to get the wave beam. But more importantly, we now have a bit of a wide beam effect, so that's pretty nice. Also, with the wave beam, you can now shoot it and you see. You can expose some of the blocks. So it's a nice touch. But the important thing was snagging that. Because now, with the more fake lava, we can actually go through here and we'll see those two worms again. Eventually, we'll see those two worms. I really want to see what's up there, though. You know what? Let me indulge my curiosity, because I really don't remember. I'll be right back. After indulging my curiosity, I realized I was going to be blocked by a super missile door. We'll be heading back there eventually. But anyway, time for us to continue onward. And Hey, it's that worm room! Except we're on the other side. With tender underbellies, of course. And we just murder them in cold blood, because they're just simply in our way. If you don't kill that guy there, you can simply shoot him backwards a little bit and actually generate a little space so you can bomb him again. Anyway, before you do that, energy tank. Easy one to get. The only one in Norfair. So you might as well take full advantage of it, right? And also, remember to use it for speed burst practice. Because those dastardly worms that get in your way. Are worms worthless? I don't know. Can't say I've found myself enthralled by a worm anytime soon, so. Anyway. We continue onward through here and we'll eventually lead our way to the area known as Ridley. Because we are well on our way there. And we got everything to head there actually, so. Also don't run into a vine like an idiot. And actually, leads to this pretty, interesting but odd fight with the Spore Spawn remix. Anyway, the whole challenge here is to shoot the, vines that you see up there. It's not particularly difficult. I mean, the guy doesn't provide a threat. Really, all I have to do is just hit that floating ripper. Do your thing with that, freeze it a few times, and you'll be all set. And always remember to refreeze it, because he frees himself rather quickly. Once you do that, he falls down, but he's clearly breathing, so he's not dead. There must be a reason for that. And I don't think it's because of Samus being inhumane, because she kills a lot of indigenous beings here in cold blood, just for being in the way. But what's this? Another cutscene. That's right, boys and girls! Ridley is headed to Ridley. He's so egotistically sent into an area named after himself. Anyway, going right is a bit of a dead end, so we're not gonna do that. Unless you know how to infinite bomb jump. Then you can sequence break a little bit. But the key here is to go left. Now, with the ability to sequence break, I can actually avoid the next boss fight. But as you see, we have a submissile door here. But the key here is we need to go up and we need to look. And, whoa, looks like our friend's been busy. Interesting. Well, we're blocked off here, so it doesn't look like we can do jack. So you have to do the most logical thing. You retreat. I'm not a big fan of plot advancement of this sort. I really am not. I just think it's a little pointless. But the whole idea is for you to retreat, and then all of a sudden an event occurs. Namely, that little monster is eating through quite a bit of earth here. I never liked it. It's like, it just, your way to advance is to simply go back? Seriously? Come on. That just doesn't make sense to me. It just seems like backwards to me. It's not the worst example I've ever seen, but it is an example. And anyway, once you get here, oh, easy boss fight alert. Heavy emphasis on the easy boss fight. This bug just comes right after you, with no regard for you or it, and leaves its freaking thing wide open. But he gets a little faster, which is a little bit annoying, but still. He's just so easy to destroy, and once you get that out of the way, he then will courageously and nice and kindly rid himself just to help you advance within our super missile tank. Did that make sense to you? It didn't to me, okay? I never liked that in video games. It reminded me of the Jolly Roger Base, Super Mario 64. The first It was the very first star you can get there, where you had to wait. You had to wait. And you had to swim to the other side just so the eel would free itself and then come after you. Which to me felt utterly pointless. Also, Desogeekas are here, as well as the Holtzes and Violas. If you remember anything from the original really I hated the area. I just hated it because it felt like it didn't fit. The music was very haunting and stuff. That fit very well. I felt it was the only thing to fit, though, legitimately. Also, I believe you can go down here and end up in another area. I'm not going to try it. Maybe not. Maybe not. It looks like it might not have worked out that way. But I didn't like it for that, and I also didn't like it for the ton of fake floors. Also, speaking of fake floors, our friend here is going to show us that there is a fake floor. And there we go. Now, if you missed that one, never fear. You can always go back and get it. No problem there. But I never liked it. I was never a fan of it. I never have been. I never will be. Also, there's a lot of enemies here. A lot of enemies. I think they got a little happy here. I think they might have gotten a little bit of happy here. Also, no, Holtz, no. That's not gonna work. The music always fit for me, but just the area never felt right to me. And we have false floors and false lava on one occasion. You have false lava on a couple occasions. Like, really, game? The original. I just couldn't believe it. It felt dumb. Anyway, really to me, also is pretty infamous because it has some pretty brutal shine spark puzzles. Also, has dissolvable block shit. Yay! Also, fuck you, Holtz. Fuck you, Holtzy. And also, the Desogeeka is drowning in lava, and I couldn't give a damn. I know, I'm a cold person. Anyway, this is the shaft you would have dropped down had you not gotten the E-Tank from earlier. So, don't pay it any mind. Just use the opportunity to explore the rest of the area, but ultimately you have to go down. Ah, come on. And get another not-so-well-hidden missile tank. I'm being reminded a little bit. I'm reminding myself of Spyro 3 Year of the Dragon. You'll never find these eggs in a million years. You'll never find these missile tanks in a million years. Looks down. Oh, there's a missile tank there. Shine Spark Puzzle, and we'll be doing that next. Because this area right here, there's two areas in this game that really made me pretty good at Shine Sparking. It was really because there's a bunch of these crazy ones, especially dealing with this whole shaft right here. And, excuse me. And Chozodia later on. But that area we can do very quickly, actually. You just have to chain a Shine Spark, which isn't that hard. Chain Shine Sparks in this area is not very hard at all, because you can just simply use these platforms up here. You know, do that. And then simply storm your way through, like so. As long as you can chain it with the ramp, you're good. And then once you do, you're in good shape. Now, there's two missile tanks here, and they're going to be a little bit of a pain to get. So, you're going to have to bear with me here, because I might not get it first try. What you have to do is you have to do this. Shoot that. And this is where things get complicated. Right there, you have missiles. Now, you have to get the missile tank, but you have to do is you need to somehow cling. And that's all dissolvable blocks down there. So, you want to make things a little bit miserable for yourself? That would be the way to do it. And there's our dissolvable right there. This is where things are going to get really complicated. I'm definitely not going to get this first try. Because things have to go right! There you go. There you go. Okay, one. I got one, but that's not the hard part. The hard part's to come. Oh god, the hard part's to come. That works. It's weird, it's dumb, but it works. Damn, I can't believe I did that first try. Last time took me like 8 tries to do that because grabbing from the missile blocks, grabbing from dissolvable blocks is not the most reliable science. But this really is the area that I think really helps you become a good shine sparker. This game rewards skilled shine sparking. It really does. I don't know what made this game decide that was the way to go, but it's clear that this game does have an admiration for it. Now, of course, that's not the only one. There's actually another one right up ahead. Right here, and it's just as... it's probably more difficult, actually, than those two I got. You have to go right here. I believe right here. It's somewhere here. I know that for a fact. Right there. So, in order to do this, you have to generate a shine spark. And the best way to generate a shine spark is going back in that shaft. Going up here and doing it. Ready, set, go. You go down here and you simply use that. You have to use that save room, otherwise you have no chance of this, and hopefully the game does not confuse your jump for a basic regular jump. Because if it does that, you can't perform a shine spark when you want to. It's kind of annoying. It's amazing how much mileage you had to put on these shine sparks, but it isn't the hardest shine spark at all. That's in Chozodia, and that one, oh, when I do that one. Like I said, I'm gonna try to get everything, but you know, things have to go right. The game has to cooperate. Fuck Kimmy game. Come on. Ah! I love how I was just hanging in midair. Really. It did feel like I was hanging in midair there. Alright, no BS now. Come on. I got hit by a viola. Are you... be right back. I'm getting this right. And I don't care how many tries it takes. Ta-da! Now you have to start another shine spark. Congratulations. Right there. And then the fun part begins. A bombing race puzzle of doom. If you have the space jump, you have a better chance at this, but if you don't, you're gonna have hell. Because you have almost no time to react. None. Which is the worst part about this. But I'll try it again. Let's save this until I have the space jump. It'll be a lot easier that way. I'm good, but I'm not that good at this. Anyway, we're gonna be locked when we go up here, so that's gonna be kind of a... as you see, we're gonna be kind of locked out, so can't do that. But we have 2 doors to go in, so let's check them out. And this way, I believe, leads to a dead end, actually. Yeah, it does lead to a dead end. Actually, leads to 2 dead ends. There's 2 ways into this room. So, let's not worry about that. That just leaves this way to go. And this way is going to lead us straight to Ridley. So, Don't be afraid to actually look at this area. If you go down there, you'll end up back at the room below, so you don't want to do that. Also, one of these areas is legit and actually holds an item, so thanks a lot, Gamma. I did not need you to do that. Not a bad subterranean subterfuge there. There we are. One of these is going to lead to a pit. It looks like I picked the right one. You can see the circle there. There we are. Really has a lot of missile tanks, and it's very easy to miss them. I think this is where I missed most of my items the first go around. There's 13 missile tanks here, I believe. And 3 energy tanks and 3 super missile packs. So we have a bunch of stuff, to say the least. And we also have a bunch of multiviolas here, which are thankfully not nearly as tough as they were in the original game. But also, don't forget to go up here. But you thought they would just do that to you? Come on. Anyway. Blocked by a super missile tank. Super missile block, rather. But, as they say, you gotta bring it to get it, so I think that's all worth it in the end. Wouldn't you agree? Nice thing about Crate and Ridley's areas, I don't feel they're overblown. I don't feel they're too big or too small. I feel they're a pretty good size. You can really get to them quickly, if you wish. If not, if you want to take the long way, oh yeah, game's fine with that too, obviously, but I always enjoyed that. Also, that's dissolvable blocks down there, so if you fall down there, well, tough rocks, pal. You'd have to go all the way back, I believe, and then end up back here, so you don't want that. Up. There's our third super missile tank. Not bad. Not bad at all. It doesn't look like we can go anywhere here, so actually, we have to go down, it looks like. So I spoke too soon again. Also, if you really don't care about this room, I believe there's one room here where you can actually do that. You can bomb the floor and go underneath all the enemies and not get burned. It's pretty nice. There we go. So if you go to the right, you'll end up back in the long shaft at the end there. Of course, we're not going to do that. We're going to go here, we're going to go to the save room. And instead of doing that right now, I'm actually going to go ahead and Idor, that can only mean one thing. That means Ridley! Ridley's coming to town! Well, apparently not. Apparently you have to do stuff first. Namely, you have to snag the third and final unknown item. Because I guess that somehow gets really pissed off. And then, oh yeah, snag the energy tank behind. Because that's nice. So really it's nice enough to give you a little bit of a head start, seemingly. But he's definitely not going to give you any more of a head start now. Also, that's a lot of missiles I have right now. So anyway, as you go through here, you'll notice Meldor, we're screwed. And Meldor here, turn around. Oh, hey, it's Ridley! And this, unfortunately, is a laughably easy-ass fight. Shoot the mini fireballs. Once he gets pissed off, fire away, and don't stop firing. Don't stop at all. Stay in the pocket, and he'll be down before you know it. Laughably easy fight. It's unfortunate that it is like that, but that fight is laughably easy. It's typical of a Ridley fight where you just basically sit in the pocket and just unleash hell on earth. And I love that about Ridley fights, truthfully. I love Ridley fights for that reason. But this right here just feels bastardized, honestly. It feels bastardized when you do it like that. I am not a fan of that at all. So, after that not so hard at all Ridley fight, I think this is where I'm going to stop this part. So, well, we've taken care of both guardians. You know what that means? Torian is calling! So, that's where we're gonna head next time. See you guys then, 40 Warriors signing off.